Hey guys, welcome to FoundFlix. In anticipation of the new TV series adaptation of Stephen King's The Mist, I wanted to look back to the 2007 film and original novella, focusing in particular on the creatures. The Mist brings with it a wide variety of other dimensional creatures, so let's break down and explain the characteristics of each of the creatures featured in The Mist, as well as some only featured in the novella, and another that was cut from the movie. The Behemoth is also known as the impossibly tall creature, and it shows up at the end of the film, causing the ground around the scout to rumble, and when it passes over, we see that it's freaking huge! It's said to be larger than anything that could possibly have lived on Earth, with an estimated size of over 240 feet. In the film, it has 6 double-jointed legs, each about 18 feet tall, with hundreds of multiple jointed appendages on its underside, as well as tentacles above its head. We also see a few flying creatures hovering around the behemoth, which could be related to the tarot buzzards, while in the novella, it instead has hundreds of scorpion flies swarming its legs. Surprisingly, the behemoth never purposefully harms anything and doesn't appear hostile in nature. Though, of course, its sheer size is dangerous in and of itself, we see it crushing utility poles without even noticing, and in the novella, due to its weight, leaves footprints the size of large SUVs in solid concrete. The tentacles from Planet X, as Norton deems them, at first look like giant squid tentacles lassoing around its victims. Oh no, not the Shermanator! Then the tentacles split open, revealing mouths which they use to consume prey, and in the film also have claws lining the sides and a slit-like mouth near the tip. All of the tentacles mostly look the same, but there is a larger, fatter tentacle that shows up after the rest, and it does seem to be in fact sniffing when searching through the room, eventually devouring the bag of dog food through a mouth on the tentacle. There is debate about what, if anything, these tentacles are attached to, since we only ever see the tentacles themselves. Some think these are the same tentacles seen on the behemoth, but they don't look long enough to reach down all the way to the ground. Plus, if the behemoth was in the area, they definitely would have heard it, and no doubt it would have caused a bunch of destruction around them. So it's possible that these are the creatures themselves, not actually attached to anything, maybe something similar to a giant deadly worm. The arachna lobster is a huge six-legged creature with lobster-like pincers and stands about 2 stories tall. Its torso appears slouched over and connects to 6 arthropod-like legs. It also has 2 deadly larger pincer-tipped arms, which it holds close to its chest like a mantis. It uses these pincers to pick up its victims, cutting them in half with the claw. Its main drive seems to be hunting for food, as it appears to smell out Private Jessup when he is left outside as sacrifice, and later takes off with Ollie's body into the mist. The tarot buzzards are nocturnal and seem to feed mostly on scorpion flies, only attacking humans if there's no other food nearby. Its skin is a pinky gray, and they resemble a pterodactyl, except with 4 membranous wings, 2 in the place of arms on its back. It also has a sharp beak-like nose attached to its head. Generally, the tarot buzzard flies to attack its prey, but it can also walk on its 3-toed talon legs. Interestingly, the tarot buzzard's appearance seems similar to a creature in another King novel from a Buick 8. That creature is also potentially from another dimension and could in fact be the same creature as the tarot buzzard in The Mist. The Grey Widower is a dog-sized spider-like creature and seems like the biggest predatory threat encountered. They have 8 legs with spiny protrusions, as well as a spiny insect-like thorax. And very weirdly, its head more resembles the appearance of a skull with 4 eyes and fangs. Like the other mist creatures, it seems that the Grey Widower is driven by its sense of smell. We see it attacks David in the Jeep, but once the door is closed, it loses their scent and wanders off. It produces spider webs like a spider wrapping up its victims, but its web strands are corrosive, able to rip through clothes and flesh, and seemingly is deadly enough to cause its victim to die. In the film, they are given the ability to lay eggs, capturing living hosts and laying thousands of eggs under their skin. These eggs appear as bulging boils on the skin as seen on the MP's chest. Then after about a day, these boils burst open, releasing hordes of hatchlings called Grey Widowlets, which appear identical to its larger counterparts, except approximately the size of normal-sized spiders, with more of a pinkish hue to their skin. Hatching so quickly has helped spread the Grey Widower quickly throughout the town, and we see near the end at Drayton's house that the entire area is covered in webs, indicating the widows have already been there. We assume that through the widower's life cycle, they grow larger in size, becoming dog-sized, and then possibly even larger from there. Because at the end, we see some huge huge spider carcasses, larger than a car, that do look like the widowers, but since they're being torched by the military, it's hard to be 100% certain. But it makes sense considering what we do see of the creature's life cycle. Scorpion flies look like a cross between a wasp and a scorpion, with purple segmented shells, and are approximately 2 to 4 feet in size. They are nocturnal, travel in swarms, and are attracted to light. It appears that during the day they live in hives, as at the end of the movie we see the military lighting up a hive with scorpion flies all in the area. Their stinger also contains a deadly neurotoxin that causes convulsions, massive swelling of the infected area, and then death, all very quickly after being stung. The terrorpede was only featured in storyboards, not in the finished film, and would have been included during the first night when the tarot buzzards get inside the store. It's shown here crawling into the food house through a window hole during that sequence. Like the other creatures featured here, the terrapede is also nocturnal. It resembles a large centipede and has large claw-like antennae with red tips, presumably from biting something. We don't know anything else about it beyond that. The killer kite is described as a nightmarish, half-seen living kite through the mist. In this concept art, we see it's quite large in scale to humans and has similar tentacles and membraned wings as seen on the tarot buzzard, and its broad surface area does look reminiscent of a kite. It's green in color with three webbed appendages tapering into tendrils which make up its body, and it only appeared in the novella, flying through the mist over David's car. The green fly is a large green insect described as having long, clear wings and resembling a twisted and deformed dragonfly. It only appears briefly in the novella, alighting on the hood of David's car, then flying off into the mist. That'll do it for my breakdown of all the creatures in the mist. Which one is your favorite? Mine's probably the Grey Widower. Are you excited for the Mist TV show? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching FoundFlix. Make sure to like, subscribe, follow. See you next time.